Oui, j'aimerais quand même partager, en tout cas, certains commentaires. Premièrement, enfin, ce que notre sœur Lydia du Ghana avait dit. En fait, nous, au cours de nos exercices, on s'est rendu compte quand même qu'il y avait des groupes de femmes qui avaient même la capacité de faire entendre et faire adhérer les autres à leur avis, à leur cause, que par rapport à d'autres groupes. Donc, cette question de genre, elle a bien fait de le souligner, ne doit pas se focaliser
uniquement sur les femmes, il y a à côté d'autres groupes. Alors j'aimerais rebondir sur la question, la grande question, sans pourtant y trouver une réponse ici, mais elle pose bien la question de Mohamed concernant ces différents niveaux de prospective. Comment articuler, mais comment mener un exercice de prospective à l'échelle locale avec des acteurs sur un territoire, alors qu'il y a une prospective nationale? Comment articuler ces différents niveaux? Il y a même des catégories de prospective qui, quand je prends l'exemple de Madame, plutôt avec les organisations paysannes. Je pense que c'est de bonnes questions qui sont posées. Je trouve que vraiment le GECAD, à travers ces sessions, en tout cas, est une bonne occasion pour au moins ouvrir les voies vers un chantier comme ça, au sein duquel ceux qui sont intéressés peuvent se retrouver et réfléchir et trouver des articulations. Merci.
Merci. Je voudrais apporter un aperçu de réponse à Madame Kansani sur la question des handicapés, et peut-être qui rejoint également les questions de capacité des hommes et des femmes. À notre avis, l'initiative prospective a sa valeur ajoutée, notamment au niveau local, du fait que les facilitateurs doivent travailler sur une approche d'inclusivité totale, c'est-à-dire ne pas exclure une composante lorsqu'ils font l'identification au niveau de la localité, au niveau du territoire. Elles doivent également faire montre de capacité à s'adapter au territoire en termes d'utilisation de langue même, parce que nous avons pu utiliser la langue locale pour bien faire passer le message de temps en temps. Donc, ils doivent avoir les techniques qui leur permettent de faire en sorte que l'ensemble des parties prenantes soient actives. Au niveau de l'initiative et puisse s'exprimer comme tel. Donc, en ce qui concerne la cohérence entre le local, je parlerai de l'expérience NEPAD en Afrique. Peut-être que nous n'avons pas beaucoup valorisé l'approche prospective, mais ça pourrait être un exemple du fait que. On a pu identifier les préoccupations, on a pu donner la possibilité aux communautés de se projeter. Par exemple, dans notre région, les organisations paysannes ont travaillé d'abord ensemble pour donner leur perspective, pour élaborer les plans régionaux d'investissement, par exemple, ou bien les plans nationaux d'investissement. Donc, je pense que la prospective est un outil important et il faudrait le valoriser. Maintenant, il faut savoir comment, à quel niveau, parce que ça demande du temps, ça demande les moyens, les ressources, que soient les ressources humaines, les ressources en termes d'équipement, en termes de moyens technologiques, etc. Et aussi les questions, les principes de subsidiarité, de niveau d'intervention. Merci.
Merci. Okay, before we go into further questions, I'd like actually to ask those who think or who had talked to me about having suggestions for other collective action. So you can come. Reza, talk to me. Yeah? Do you want, in 3 minutes, as a matter of fact, give us an idea, and if people would want to join you, if you have enough people, again, you will have a table, but present your initiative, because he had talked to me during lunchtime that he would want to present something. Yeah, you can come here. 3 minutes. Our co-chair is monitoring the time.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I'm Reza, WIPART Iran representative and program officer of WIPART Asia and Pacific. As this morning Jim mentioned, we have a model, a project named Eco-Friendly Village. It is a model for building capacity for yield. Our principles and different this model with other model are basic on five concepts: waste management, use of renewable energies, organic and healthy crops, eco club, including for youth and women, and climate smart agriculture. Most important difference between these model with earlier models like organic village, bio village, and eco village is we consider both rural residences and farms, and we include five most important aspects. For example, organic village only consider organic and healthy crops. In BioVillage, mostly we focus on eco-friendly activities, but in this model, we do all of five mentioned concepts. Thank you for time.
Well, you can actually, if you want, you can stand here because we are gonna take votes. Just stand by because there is no other chair, so just join the presenters, please. Okay, so now we are moving into asking you if you have an idea which initiative you would like to join. If you have a very, again, urgent question, if someone has a question that would really make the difference in their decision which catalyst to join, you can ask it. If not, we'll move to hand raising. Okay, Fernando? Yes? One question, one urgent, very urgent question that will help you decide.
Mi nombre es Fernando López, soy agricultor, secretario general de Coprofam, Organización Regional de Sudamérica, de pequeños y medianos agricultores familiares. La pregunta es, a partir del reconocimiento de la importancia de comenzar por el nivel nacional en los espacios de diálogo, cómo generar las capacidades de las organizaciones de agricultores para que ese diálogo sea equilibrado. ¿Por qué? Porque creemos que los agricultores familiares, que somos el 70% por lo menos a nivel mundial de la generación de alimentos, muchas veces no está visibilizado a nivel de las decisiones de política, tanto de investigación o políticas públicas. Por lo tanto, sería bueno, en esos espacios de diálogos local, regional y global, preguntar qué rol tendrán los pequeños y medianos agricultores dentro de 20 o 30 años en la agricultura.
Yes, please.
I am Esther Penunia from the Asian Farmers Association, or AFA, one of the regional organizations who did grassroots foresight work together with Elizabeth Atananga of PROPAC and Fernando Lopez of Coprofam. I have a suggestion, because I'm put in a dilemma. I have to choose, for example, what kind of collective action I would like to join in the six. But I think that there's something complementary in some of this, and it has been mentioned earlier. Like, for example, collective actions at local or rural communities. So I find that in number one, putting farmers first, in number three, engaging local actors for applying foresight for local research development. And in number five, a shared vision for the future. These are all talking about foresight work with rural communities involving farmers, women and men, and local authorities, young and old people in the rural communities. So I think one collective action that we can do together is how do we put grassroots foresight in action with local communities involving farmers organizations, because we see farmers organizations that they can be the driving force in this grassroots foresight work, especially farmers organizations at the national level and at the regional level, because they can multiply the foresight work at the country and at the local. Then I have second category. The second category is on with the research agencies. So I see that, for example, one, youth planning rural futures. These are all young professionals in agriculture. And then the second one is on strengthening foresight capacity to achieve rural development. These are collective actions. These are foresight work by regional fora. I think we can combine this. What kind of foresight work is needed so that our research institutions can be able to really do foresight analysis, and then can help the grassroots and can help the national farmers organizations do this grassroots foresight work at the local level. And then the third collective action I can see is this one on balancing specialization and diversification in our foresight work in Philippines and in Indonesia and even in India. One of the action plans that has emerged from the foresight work is that they would like to have sustainable, integrated, diversified rural livelihoods. So if we can do something on that collective action, I think that's also good. So rather than divide ourselves into six or seven with a whiteboard, with an additional thing, maybe we could divide ourselves into three groups.
Fantastic. I mean, definitely. And I can see that your audience actually is applauding. You have took us a step further, so thank you for that. And as a matter of fact, the initiatives that talk, as you mentioned, that this would be cross-cutting initiatives, and those who have mentioned the local, for example, including the local actors in the initiatives, or diversification versus specialization, they could be your expert, you know, advisors or consultants on how actually to take their specialization in the topics like they mentioned in when you are talking about your farmer organizations development. So this could be a good fit. They have the expertise on this matter, like territorial action and or specialization versus diversification, and you want to take these concepts and apply them to your work. So I thank you for mentioning that, so you can merge instead of having six round tables. The use we will see, and that's why as a first exercise, as a matter of fact, we would like again to get a feel so that we know, for example, are we gonna have the use by themselves, or are we gonna ask them to merge and pick the group that they would want to merge with. So I will go one by one. This is just an exercise. It's no, shouldn't be any feeling for anyone. One, please, I hope that our panelists again accept that. We'll just ask, just to get a feel who would want, do you have a comment? Who would want to be with which catalyst?
Well, I think I would support Ma'am Esther's stand on integrating different collective actions, because okay. I think with the six collective actions, and we have a number of people who might be divided, we would have six collective, we can come up with six collective actions that might not be of quality, But then if we merge together and we can have different perspectives, then we can probably have two or three collective actions that will be more substantial. And for the young people, I wouldn't know if it would be okay also that if we, I think there are young people here, it would be good to have the young people's perspective in the different collective actions.
Excellent.
As well. And so we would be achieving the collective action for young people when we have young people representing in each endeavor.
Okay, so we are reaching a decision, but I want Robin also to tell us his perspective.
Well, not so much my perspective, but something which will make you more comfortable, because the idea is not to work in silos, it's not to work on independent discussions. Remember, Iman told you that there will be a session, the fifth session, which we call the World Cafe. And in that session, you will have more than 1 hour to share with the other roundtable what you have done and incorporate maybe some inputs or ideas of other roundtables into yours and reciprocally. And after that, there will be an additional hour to finalize the posters and the presentation. So there is a stream of work which will be helping you to concentrate on a few topics, but there will be a very good 1 hour and 15 minutes where you will have plenty of time to see what the other groups have done so far and you can contribute to them. So there is a crossing also there possibility. So based on Esther's proposal, we could have 2 or 3 roundtables, but then we will have 1 hour after a good discussion where you can share and also propose. The youth are in one table, but you can be also proposing things in what will be offered by the other roundtables. Okay, that's okay. To make life comfortable for everyone.
Absolutely. So, is our panelist okay with merging instead of having 6 roundtables, having say 3 roundtables? Are you okay with that? Any disagreement? Because we are going to move. Yes.
Yeah, I think the proposal by the lady, if I didn't catch her name, but I think the 3 groups that she was proposed were excellent ways of grouping, you know, the presentations. Although there are, of course, interactions across.
Yes.
Yeah, and we would like to explore that further. So maybe if we can give, because I'm interested in listening a lot more about the kind of foresight work that have been done in the Asian countries in terms of the specialization and diversification issues, and how this could be models that we could look at.
Excellent. Thank Fantastic. You. So thank you very much for that. To sum up, actually, and correct me if I'm wrong, I'm just trying to sum up, we have one table on putting farmers first, and we have all the farmer organizations on this table and who wants to join them. Okay? We have one table for the regional fora, all of the regional fora, and who wants to join them. So farmer organization is, again, the presenter was Ms. Elizabeth Atengana, but she will be joined by the other farmer organizations that with us we have Asia and we have Latin America. And the other table is what Mr. Ojiju, Dr. Ojiju has presented from FARA, but we have also Kakari and we have Arenina, so we have other 2 regional fora that will be on the same table and you can join them. The suggestion was that the presentation by Dr. Mami Somari on engaging local actors and that of Dr. Jojo Baido-Forsan on balancing specialization and diversification. You have actually the option and the privilege that the others do not have is to move actually from one roundtable to the other, providing your expertise in your in the area that you have presented on. So you will be their consultant to develop collective action together. So actually, you can be in more than one collective action. So you can be with the regional fora and you can be with a farmer organization. Okay, so spend some time here and some time there. The last thing, of course, the Jim has suggested that he will join either the regional fora then or the farmer organizations, right? And you said the farmer organizations. So I leave this to you. The youth will be distributed, but you said that you are interested in Asia, okay? But the youth will be represented, so I leave it to them. Monsieur Nothomb, which group do you want to join? We have farmer organizations and we have regional fora that have Arenina, who is responsible actually for the area that you are covering, which is the Mediterranean area.
Madame, je pense que si vous me posez la question comme ça, je pense que je dois aller me joindre à l'idée des forums régionaux. Mais je voudrais quand même bien revenir en arrière pour dire nous ne pouvons pas couper la réalité en petits morceaux. Il y a une grande idée qui est sortie ce matin, il faut être proactif, voir l'avenir. Il y a une deuxième grande idée qui est dit, il faut une action locale et il faut des groupes qui s'organisent au niveau local. La troisième idée est, il faut des pouvoirs locaux en face des organisations locales et il faut la mobilisation de l'opinion publique ou du soutien politique national et international. Je trouve très utile pour personnellement l'idée de forums régionaux au sens mondial du mot, pour dire comment on doit faire la prévision. Cela peut frapper les opinions publiques, y compris des dirigeants nationaux, parce que quand on fera des prévisions sur ce qui se passe dans cette partie du monde, ils vont en prendre leur part. Et puis, il faut prendre les remèdes. Et les remèdes, c'est rapidement pour dire, si on veut corriger la prévision qui est pour le moment l'exode rural et la déperdition du monde sous-régional, il faut prendre des mesures. Alors on entre dans lesquelles ? Et alors on s'adresse d'abord aux organisations internationales, puisque nous sommes dans ce cadre, mais d'abord aux gouvernements nationaux, et surtout on suscite des actions locales de femmes, de jeunes, des autres, des prospecteurs, etc. Donc pour moi, la voie la plus utile pour le moment, c'est de se joindre à un forum de prévision régionale qui va pouvoir se rapprocher de la réalité, mais intégrer jeunes, femmes, agriculteurs, autres secteurs, politiques, funding, tout ça va ensemble.